I need to get like a better intro phrase, than just like "What's up, everybody," which I always say. But to be honest, I feel like normally when I pop in, well, it depends if I'm due starting soon, there's people here, but if I don't, then there's not. So, but in general, I need something better and more memorable than "What's up, everybody." Let's do a cosmic egg run, huh? And then after we kill the fate, we'll switch over to the underworld acorn. But for starters, let's see if we can hook ourselves up with a good chaos boon. Oh, and now that I met Thanatos and Theseus, well, I guess I can't give gifts to Theseus, but now that I met Thanatos, I need to push for some nectars this run. I am gonna have to go on pause at some point, because I have a delivery person coming. I actually love that. Imagine me with white hair and a modicum and no self-control, and that's Zeus. That's actually fucking great. God, this game is good. So, I am gonna have to keep an eye on my phone, but just to like intercept incoming notifications, but. Okay, your attack is stronger with 15% chance to crit. Your cast is decent now. Your dash strike deals more damage. Let's get the cast upgrade. Get that good train noise in the background. Let me know, by the way, if you can hear my fan. I hope you cannot. But I cannot hear my own audio, so these things happen, unfortunately. I don't hate the sword. It isn't my favorite. It's not. I'll have to rank them at some point, but I would rank the sword below the fists, below the shield, but probably around the same tier as the spear. The fists, man, that's my shit. The fists are like all. Every time I have a good run, I have the fists. I can't. And the bow. Coronoct and the gun Exegryph, I struggle with those a lot. The sword isn't terrible, but I much prefer the fists and the shield. Love to hear that you can't hear the fan. Yeah, the chaos aspect of shield is what I've been using. I had a really great run earlier, with that one. Yeah, no, chaos looks fucking phenomenal. And like, that's so cute, actually. Aw, because chaos is Nyx's parent, you know? I like that chaos is like pretty gender neutral looking. I mean, it's just kind of like weird and fucked up, but not a weird or fucked up dude or lady. That's pretty cool. For the next four encounters, you can't earn any obol. Afterwards, you deal 60%. No. For the next three encounters, you take bonus damage from traps. Afterwards, your special deals 73% damage. Yeah, okay. Let's do this. Thanatos? Is that who you're referring to? Because I did finally get to meet him. Actually, earlier today. If you wanted to, you could go back and watch the archive and see where I met Thanatos for the first time. It was pretty great. Yeah, I just met Thanatos and Theseus today. So I think the last characters I need. Well, I don't want to spoil anything. There are only a few characters I haven't met yet now. And I know one of them I only meet when I beat the game, and the other one I can't be sure. But wouldn't surprise me if it was the case also. That's I get it, honestly, Evan. I get it. Thanatos, he's fucking cute, and his scythe is real cool. My boyfriend is Hypnos for sure. He's just so cute. I there's nothing I wouldn't do for Hypnos. But there's, to be honest, there's a lot of lovable characters in this game. I should do like a, I should make a tier list and rank them. That would be fun. I wonder if there's, I feel like Zeus is the only non-horny character, and I think that might just be because we as a human people know too much about him to be horny for him. At least that's how I feel. Because it's not that he's like horribly ugly looking, but it's like, yeah, that's Zeus, huh? When we played Aeon's End for the first time, Evan immediately picked up the Grimdark Boy to play, and then flipped him over, look at the lore, and say, sorry, the others, they do not understand. That's so fucking funny. No, don't say that. God. I mean, it's like, he doesn't look terrible, you know? I mean, he looks fine. He looks like a. Like, what if somebody was like, huh, what if Zeus was sexy? But I can't find him sexy, because it's like, yeah, that's. Zeus, that's what he looks like. He's a piece of shit. I know this. I honestly might just. I'll probably end up doing a fist run after this. So now my special deals 73 damage. Zaxxas. Is that the name of the character from Aeon's End? A game I have not played or even heard of, to be honest with you. Right, here's, I'm glad we got him because, yeah, see, it's like it's just Zeus. He's like it's a, he's a non-sexual object, you know. I do love that his beard and hair turn into clouds as they kind of like fall down him. Okay, I will play Aeon's End. Right, I remember this. I remember you talking about it. I will definitely play this with you. At some point after COVID is over, which is seems like a thing that I should stop saying because I don't think it's ever going to go away fully. At some point we need to get together and play Grimslingers because I got that a while ago and I like it a lot and I don't have anybody to play it with. That's okay. I'm sure there will be other characters I would like to play. Move, asshole. This is not a good run. It's a fine. This is a warm-up run. And also Zaxxas is a nemesis. Seems like this Zaxxas character is pretty popular. Wow. Thank you, Ares. Jesus. Let's do Curse of Vengeance. Now I just need to get a Daedalus Hammer, so I can get that thing where it's like you have less than you have a lot less health, but every time you swing your sword, you gain two, and it's like fuck yes. Oh, it's a survive. Okay, a four Zaxxas game. Yeah, this is definitely a warm-up run. Oh my word, I'm not doing good. That nap threw me off my rhythm. Jesus, man, I'm just like. Yeah, no, Athena's Dash Boon. I talked about this earlier about how it's just like the most busted boon in the game, and if you see it, you'll always grab it. It's like it generally in Hades things are balanced pretty well, and so it's like, I'm sorry, you've thrown off the Empress's groove. That was one of my favorite movies when I was a kid. We would watch that all the time. My dad always falls asleep during movies, and I mean, to be fair, he works like a fucking dog, so I get it. But he would fall asleep. He fell asleep during the Emperor's New Groove one time, and after that scene where Pacha and the Emperor are, they have to get on the water, and eventually, you live with somebody enough that you just stop turning the movie off when they fall asleep. You're just like, okay, whatever. It's the Emperor's New Groove. You probably didn't give a shit about it anyway. We're just gonna keep watching it. So he fell asleep, and there's that scene where Pacha and Kuzco are like, they fall down the waterfall or whatever, and then afterwards, Pacha's like trying to do mouth to mouth on him and shake him awake, and he's like, your Highness, Emperor, are you all right?" And my dad asleep on the couch is like, "Yeah, why do you ask?" It was the funniest fucking thing. Yeah, I had Poseidon's earlier, and I was struggling because I had Poseidon's Dash Boon, and I was fighting and the fists, and I was fighting a bunch of flame wheels, and it was a really struggle to. To get rid of the flame wheels without taking damage. It was very difficult. Ooh, normally I go for the two boon, but I don't have a hammer yet. I would normally go for the Trial of the Gods, but I don't have a Daedalus hammer. And I would like to get one. Yeah, that's basically the hammer upgrades are almost always like. Yeah, it's like if you see a hammer, you go for the hammer. If you see the Athena Dash Boon, you pick it up. Those are pretty much the only hard and fast rules of my play so far, my gameplay that I go by is like, I know this is too strong, so I gotta go for it. Not too strong, but strong in a way that I feel I should go for it. And it, obviously not too strong. It's not like it trivializes the fucking game. I still haven't beaten it, so. Yeah, Curse Slash, here we go. You have 60% health. You only have 40% of your health, but your attack restores to every hit. I usually go for that one. Your attack becomes a big chop that deals 90 base damage. Hold attack to strike rapidly, dealing 25 base damage per hit. I do like that. I haven't used it, obviously. Make sword play like fists. Okay. Yeah. 25 base damage per hit. But that sustain on the Curse Slash is so good. I don't think this is going to be my run anyway, so I'm not going to go for that. I'm going to do this. 220. Palm. Palm. I'll do Flurry. Palm. You don't need to stop holding attack when you dash. Interesting. Fuck yeah. That sounds very helpful. Oh my word, you're right. That's fucking incredible. I also think it's Electo. You're so valid. I heard there's like a something else with Meg if you keep playing, but I haven't pushed for her, her friendship bonuses or anything. She's definitely gonna kill me. I'm playing super sloppy. Oh, yep, there it is. I love Meg. Yeah, I didn't think I was gonna get out of that one, but what are you gonna do? No hypnos.
Seems to have taken somewhat of a liking to me, Nix.
They mentioned me, did they? I thought perhaps that they had long forgotten. You should know they are my mother and my father, child. We have not spoken since the dawn of time.
That's... Oh.
She looks great, man. There's so much. The character design in this game is obviously a big part of the appeal. But Nyx does look really fucking good. For me, it's Yurtis, but that's to be expected, you know. Love Dusa. Yeah, all right. We're gonna go back in with the Boon of Chaos and see what we can do. Oh, hey! Nice! Slay 10,000 foes or more and then see Garry's. I don't think I'm quite there. Oh, I'm close though. All right, what's the game want me to use? The shield? All right, fine. I like the shield. We'll do the shield. Which one? I always do charge throw with Chaos because you get the bonuses. Yeah, it's wild. The fact that when you're charging your bull rush, you don't take any damage from the front. And you can also spin while you're charging it, so it's like. Shield's pretty fucking strong. That feel indeed. I can't. I'm still reading about laughing. The Phil window love goddess to call you godling. Oh, I get to see Dionysus again. Hell yeah. Who we getting? Who we hitting? There we go. Pretty. Oh, he's so pretty. Oh my god, yes, if your health is left, your encounters return to the threshold. Your dash causes hangover near where you started. Ooh. I think I'm gonna go for return to the threshold. Yeah, hangover is awesome, I love it. And that special with the dash was tempting, but After Party saved my ass a couple times in earlier runs today, so I'm learning its value. Strong Drink also is an extremely good Dionysus boon. I found that out. The one where it's like your fountains fully restore your health and you get bonus damage for everyone you've drank from. That one, I found that was really strong. Yeah, 45% is like, it's a lot. And especially it's a percentage, so as you increase your max health, so does the threshold. Yeah, After Party's good. That was my simulation engine signaling that they are complete. I was about to ask, who leveled up? You just finished compiling that? Oh my god, that's fucking funny. For reference, Evan, earlier I was doing hangover math on hangover damage and trying to decide which boon I should take, and I was like, I decided to take this one because 80 is more than 50. And John was like, I'll have to check the math on that. And then that was like literally the last time I was streaming earlier today. That was fucking funny. Alright, let's go see Aphrodite. The one thing that frustrates me about the shield is that I always expect the charge to take me over gaps in the floor, the way that my dash does. And it's fine that it doesn't. I get why that would be more powerful and probably need nerfing. But I always, in my head, it feels like it should. And I'm always thrown off when I go to charge and I hit the wall. Oh, I forgot. I keep forgetting I have an upgraded cast. Chaos Shield with Doom on the shield throw. Oof. Wave of Despair. After you take damage, damage foes around you inflict weak. Any Heart Chamber are rewards are worth more. Your dash deals damage where you end, inflicting weak. These are pretty good. I'm going to do this one, I think, because this one is good, but I want to try and get the Athena dash. And this one is fine, but I don't think it's going to be as useful. Especially in comparison to the Dionysus boon, which does that, but better. Like, significantly better, actually. Artemis is great. Yeah, I'm gonna go for the Trial of the Gods. Is that the one where it's like every time you land a shot, Artemis fires a little ammo? Because that's insane. It's like if you land an attack, a special or a cast, it she fires a little 10 damage arrow. And it doesn't seem like it'd be that much, but the amount, but it's like every time you do something that does damage, you get an extra 10 damage. It's fucking bonkers. Oh, I should have picked Aphrodite. I learned my lesson last time and I didn't do it. Fuck. I should have gone for Aphrodite first. Yeah, I wish I had. I regret it as soon as I did it because I learned my lesson about that earlier. That I was like, oh, Aphrodite will be fine. She'll probably just inflict weak on me or whatever. And no, it's her fucking. Those hearts are so fucking damaging. Let's get a call. We don't have a call yet. I'm sorry, Aphrodite. Please don't hate me. But wait, I have the shield, so. He literally said the exact same thing I said. Can I block the shield damage? I can. Christ. I can't tell if you're really horny or if, Evan, if I just don't hang around horny people that often anymore. Little column A, little column B. That sounds right. Because I used to be, my old Kewl was like extremely, like full of just extremely horny people. But now that I'm single, it's like I don't talk like that as much anymore, I guess. And so every time you say like, that feel when no love guys who calls you godling, I'm like, damn. But I mean, it's not bad or anything. It's just like it always surprises me a little. Resist some damage from nearby foes' attacks. Your cast shoots farther at this one. This is fucking strong. Popping that, bumping that cast up is really good. Hammer. Yeah. Because it's not like you ever said anything that made me uncomfortable. But. Because if you had, you'd know about it for sure. But it's always just like, oh my word, and it makes the humor of it land a little bit more because I'm not expecting it. God. Doing that bull rush through a bunch of enemies is so good. The bull rush on the shield scratches the same itch in my brain as the loader in Risk of Rain 2's Rocket Punch does. And if you haven't played Risk of Rain 2, you should, if only so you can play loader. While you dash, your throw is faster and deals 200% damage. Your bull rush instead fires a piercing shot that deals 80 damage. I don't think it's gonna be that. Your special deals 50 damage to foes around you when you catch it. Yeah, none of these are too bad. I feel like charge shot would be worse for me than bull rush, but I mean it is a it's like a double damage, right? And the only difference is I don't move with it, so that's not terrible. And I do dash a lot. Getting over it wants me back. A sign from the hammer. Right. Yeah, these are all pretty good. Let's do. I'm gonna do this one. Because I feel like this one is the one that is going to require me. Oh, okay. require me to alter my gameplay style the least, and I tend to with the ones that are like with the hammer is when it's like, hey, your dash strike is now your objectively most powerful move and you have to be fucking using it all the time. I always struggle to use those to the best of their potential. Holy shit. And it doesn't throw your shield anymore. Yeah, seriously. It doesn't throw your shield anymore, so you can keep blocking. Essentially a bow you can swing. Hell yeah, that rules. Darkness. I'm mostly out of things to do with keys, but I have many abilities left to pay for. Let me to check my notifications. You can, but it's like, it's 10 keys for a diamond. Which is not bad, and I'm sure I'll end up making that trade at one point. The Wretched Broker. One of my favorite things about Hades is that all the little, like, underworldlings, the characters like the Wretched Broker and the House Contractor and what have you, they're all just really cute. And the chef! The little chef in the lounge. We're gonna have to stop and visit him after this so you guys can see his little animation. But all the, like, the characters who were just, like, jobs within the underworld, they're so cute. The Wretched Broker's adorable. That's who you give fish to, is the chef man. I haven't gotten to fishing yet. I can't fish yet. I don't know how to do that yet. And I would like to, you know? I like fishing. It's all I do in Stardew Valley. Two diamonds at the contractor to start fishing. Okay. I'm trying to get another diamond. I would like to ideally get a two diamond thing done today. Your dash creates a blade rift where you started. Yeah, I don't think Urge to Kill, and I don't think the dash isn't great. I do think the Agony is the way to go. I mean, I might as well get the palm. Well, there you go.
Got a feeling it's Tisiphone this time.
Does it really? Huh. I did not think it would do that. Electo and Zagreus are just having a very, like, hateful friends with benefits relationship. And I'm here for it, you know? I think it works very well for them. Oh my god, it does have Doom. Evan, you're a fucking genius. Come at me. Her blade rifts are what killed me last time I fought her. I had a great run and I just caught Bailey on the edge of one. Got her. Let the hangover get her. Not bad. I didn't even pop my Death Defiance. Yeah, if I can get that Athena dash, I'll be pretty good. Did I get my Chaos Boon for this run? No. But I didn't see him at all, and I am going to want the... I didn't manage to get my Chaos Boon, but I'm going to want the Acorn. If I have to fight the... When I have to fight the Bone Hydra. Alright, let's fucking do this. Asphodel time. I have only looked up... I know the sign says Election Free Zone, but this is in the spirit of that. I have looked up the results only once today, and it was when it was so early there weren't any for me to look at. And I have not caved to the impulse beyond that, and I feel very good about it. A little bit extra life. Yeah, I know I will too. And I know I will. You're right, John. I'm sorry. Do what you must. I know I will because I did last year. Or not last year, but last election. I stayed up watching it until we knew every single one. And it was miserable. Oh, is that what that is? Is that what that symbol means? I thought that was like the little random things you got. I did not realize that that symbol would send me to Eurydice. Or, I guess Sisyphus if I'm in Tartarus. Learning new things every day. Why did you bring him up, you idiot? Oh, it's not Orpheus' song. You kidding me? This one's all mine. He always did like going on about how I'm his muse. Well, that's because I wrote half his songs for him. But he didn't mention that, did he? Huh. Well, not exactly in those words, but Orpheus can be a little hard to pass. He can be a little hard to tolerate. A quality I hope isn't going to rub off on any of his mates. I should get back to practicing. See ya. Two random boons of yours are upgraded to the next rarity. Four random boons of yours gain one level. The next three boons you have finally upgraded. I always go for that one. I just always do. I don't know. I'm not sure if it's the objectively best option, but it's the one that I always gravitate towards every time, so. That makes sense. I think it's because I have a hard time conceptualizing in my head what upgrading my current boons would look like. And so I just go with the one that is still good, but means I don't have to worry about that. After After using your call, gain dodge chance and move speed for 10 seconds. After you dash, become sturdy and move faster. Side hustle is, I feel like, the best option here, but I don't have Second Wind yet, so I think I'm going to go for it. I do have a call, I just don't, I haven't been using it much. Dionysus, Poseidon, or not Sharon, because I don't have, I have hardly any money. Let's do Dionysus.
Off we go. Away we go.
Oh, right, it's the fucking barge. I love when I don't have to deal with the barge. That's the best. Let's fucking get him. Well, it's the one, the other, well, because what's the other one? Witch's Circle? Then yeah, I would rather have Barge than Witch's Circle. Because I bitch about Witch's Circle all the time. I think Witch's Circle is fucking, like shouldn't be in the game bad. Yeah, the Megagorgon is fucking irritating. I mean, the barge always irritates me, but now that I think about it, it is the better of the options. Yeah, I'll talk to him about that. Oh, your hangover effects deal damage faster. Ooh, strong drink. Ooh, drunken flourish. Ooh, Dionysus gave me three fucking winners. Strong drink at 5% is good. That's really good. Special inflict 7 hangover is also very good. Yeah, seriously, this is hard. These are all fucking great. Because this essentially, like, almost practically doubles my hangover damage. This is fucking one of the goats, and this is insane. 7 hangover on a throw, that's great. And I get multiple throws. I'm gonna go Drunken Flourish. I've made my decision. So many good ones here, though. Yeah, for sure. I am going to take a quick 5 and run to the restroom. So we'll be right back. We're fucking back. What's up? That took a few minutes longer than I thought it was going to because my delivery person showed up right as I was coming out of the bathroom. So, but it's good now, and you're stuck with me for a little while. What time is it? 8:45. We've been going about an hour. You're stuck with me for a little while longer. Probably a couple more hours. Hey, I have something for you. He's so sassy. I love his belt buckle. The big ol' skull there. Peep that nip! That singular nip. Aww. Gay. Man, that's some horseshit. That's not fair. It takes me a lot longer to kill those armor guys than it takes him. I barely got out of that one. What happens if you don't beat him? You just don't get the centaur heart? Okay. I don't know what I'm supposed to say when he gets like this. He's extra sassy. I love it. Yeah, if y'all could just stand in the lava for a little while. You're very valid. It's a good fucking theme. I don't know why I didn't get to gift him anything. I think maybe I have to do that in the house. Your dash creates a blade rift where you started. Your doom effects deal more damage when applied multiple times. After using Stubborn Defiance, deal more damage. What all sources of doom do I have? I get doom when I throw the shield. Well, but he came to the house, but I went up to him and I had a nectar. I went up to him after the encounter and I had the nectar and I couldn't give it to him. It didn't give me the option. It was only talk. That was all I could do. So maybe I just haven't met him enough times to start giving him stuff yet. I don't know why it didn't let me. It's me or them. Oh, my attack inflicts doom. Oh, okay. So it's not my special. My special is hangover. My attack is doom. But still, I rarely attack just once, so. Nice. I cannot take damage or heal. Ooh, I shouldn't have said that because now I need to heal. Oh, it's fine. I healed when I left anyway. It went up to 72. Yeah, that 3 HP. There we go. We're good, y'all. I'm about to serve this fucking Bone Hydra his fucking face. I'll be honest with you, I saw the dash, I didn't even look at the other two. He does look different. Is he like stronger now? Or some shit? Determines which ability he uses. Okay. I just lost my acorn. He's already impervious again? Yeah, I was gonna say, it does mean I'm doing big damage. It says Doom effects, man. There we go. That's the Hydra. Any more heads you'd like chopped off? No? No? Any more heads you'd like chopped off? I have never been all the way. I was a hair's breadth from fucking beating Theseus and the Minotaur earlier. That's the closest I've ever gotten. But yeah, this is a fucking great setup, and I would very much like to go as far as I can. I would love to beat Asterion. That'd be great. To beat Theseus and Asterion would be awesome. Champions of Elysium, I've returned. Yes, I agree, honestly. That it is like, yeah. But I don't know. Honest to God, I think Hydra's pretty fucking hard. I struggled a lot with him before. If I don't have the right weapon to deal with him, I feel like I don't do well against him pretty consistently. I am not at that point. In fact, this is only the second time I've been there today. I can get Asphodel most of the time. I don't die to the Furies that often. get far into Elysium. That makes sense. That does make sense. I did not notice the butterfly ball, or I would have dealt with it right away. Damn, I'm taking some damage here. I'm not doing the best. After blocking a foe, gain 20% damage and move speed for 10 seconds. Your special deals 50 damage to foes around you when you catch it, when you dash your specials faster. So we see explosive return, make a return. You can't deflect butterflies. I did not know that. Thank you. That's going to be helpful. Your special is 50% 50 damage to foes around you when you catch it, or when you dash, your special is faster. I'm going to do this one. Oh, the Great Shields are definitely there to prep you for the Theseus fight. Because you can't damage him from the front either. But I didn't see any of the fucking Great Shields before I fought Theseus, so it didn't help me at all.
You have met the champion, the king. Let us see if you are fit to face him once again.
You mean face both of you together, which doesn't seem particularly fair.
True, they are Ornstein and Small. If you like Asterius, there's a whole album about him called This One's for the Dancer and This One's for the Dancer's Bouquet by Moonface. It was Moonface's last album, I believe. It's fucking incredible. I heard it before I even played this, and I was like, oh, nice. But yeah, there's a whole album about the Minotaur, and it's very good. I'm getting sloppy. Damn, what the fuck was that? I didn't even see the projectile that hit me. Rough. I've never beaten him on his own. When I fought Theseus and Asteria, when I fought them together, I killed him first, and it was fine. It went perfectly fine. Phase 2 Shockwave when he lands. And I guess I just dodge it. I just dash through it. But every time I go to fight him, it's just him. I get my ass kicked. I think fighting Asterius on his own is a mini boss for somehow, and fighting him at the end of the level is the fighting the both is the real boss. Yeah, I don't want to spend my diamond yet. If you beat him solo, he starts the final kind of RP. Oh, that's nice. Tell me something, Zagreus. How is she lately? Eurydice, I mean. Her hair, fall colors or full bloom. Her poise. She's all right, Orpheus. Seems comfortable within her little place in Asphodel. The only thing that seems to bother her at all is... Alas... I cannot change the past, my friend. But that's just a technicality. I mean, you're here, she's there. So what if you're not breathing anymore? You have all eternity ahead of you. Don't you want 15 or 20%? Okay. Don't I want to see my Eurydice again? Why, yes. That more than anything, my friend. Provided she wanted to see me. You're not making this easy, Orpheus. Okay, so here he is. I cannot talk to him. It won't let me. Is there something I can do to help with all of this? I spend too much time away from the house. Please, let me know.
You are already doing what you can to help, my son. Continue doing so. I understand, and I will do my best.
I'm trying so hard to place Thanatos' voice. It sounds like one of the DBZ characters, and I can't figure out which one. See, and then he's gone, and I didn't get to give him his nectar. That I've been holding on for him for so long. How was that for Zagreus? Is it Elysium? You'll have to tell us all about it every time the greatest strike you down. You've never been there, have you? It's lush, is that a word? Feels closer to the surface. Closer to the sky. How poetic. You could have visited as part of your responsibilities. Instead you trespass, incurring wrath of fallen champions in service of your father. Yeah. Let's see here. Yeah, I can trade 10. Or no, it's 2 keys for 20 gemstones or 5 keys for a nectar. That's not bad. 5 keys for a nectar. Really isn't terrible, actually. Alright, we're going to do another run. I'm probably call off for the night. Let's see what the game wants me to be using. But I might just use the fists anyway. Oh, it was meant to be. Let's test the bond between us. The Zagreus axe wasn't a fit as good once you get a few levels on it. I believe it. I need to. I don't have any Tartarus blood, though. I'll get some more once I finish this Ares quest. Tempest Strike, Tempest Flourish, Tidal Dash. Hmm. I literally was not close enough to actually hit him with the fist. Yeah, Poseidon boons with the fists aren't great. But with the magnetic cutter, it's not really too much of an issue. Because I can pull him toward me again. Not a terrible idea. If I can get something else. Damn, I should have brought my egg. Now I have to give 21 damage to go in here. If I had brought my egg, it would have been fine. Wonder what that means if she's beyond Chaos's senses. These kind of suck, Chaos. These aren't great. Maimed Grasp is okay. Kefka. Don't remember that. The name doesn't ring a bell, unfortunately. It does, but it's like I don't remember where I should be applying it. Well, that makes sense. I did not play that. I don't want to take this one, but I've been shown it 3 times thus far today, so I should pick it up. Plus, I can always just sell it. Hell yeah, I fucking love to get an Athena boon. Damn, no dash boon. Phalanx shot, your cast damages foes in a small area and can deflect. Holy shield, after you take damage the foes around you and briefly deflect. Or replace my Poseidon special with a Athena special. Does Poseidon get mad if I do that? I'm thinking this is the best one, honestly. It's a bigger damage boost, and deflect is stronger than the pushing away, for sure. But then this is pretty... I mean, there's not really a bad option here. They'll be fine, but... Is in dual boon rooms? Okay. I'm gonna take the cast, I think, just to upgrade my arsenal. Easy peasy.
Wretches of the underworld, this is your chance.
Every time. Hammer. After using your special, deal 90 damage in an area where you land. Don't mind if I do. Oh, that's very good. Very cool and sexy. God, that is strong. I have 21 keys now. Yeah, Drunken Strike on Fists is going to be bonkers. Oh yeah, it's going to be great. I know she calls you a murderer because her job, whole job, is to punish murderers. But I wonder if they ever explain why she thinks you're a murderer, or if that's just like the only thing she can say. I mean, I guess if it was the only thing that she could say, that would make sense, but. I mean, yeah, that would make sense.
I'll pay for that. Closer to the surface.
No diamond for me today. Apparently, those are the diamonds that I've gotten so far. It's just the sword, the shield, and the fists. Not the sword, but the shield and the fists. I think I am gonna do this and swap Poseidon's special for a hangover special. Especially because it affects, it does my AoE, my quake cut too. Oh man. Love it. Ooh, no. No, not at 19 health, no. Well, yeah, okay. I guess the answer was pretty greedy. Sunken treasure heals you, didn't know that.
So that's the way it is then. Now he's angry.
Yeah, I definitely am regretting my choice now, but. Damn. Didn't have to be like this, man. Yeah, I know, buddy. Yeah, the fact that the healing items are gyros and fries is very good. Good for you, Meg. Good for her.
I got acquainted with the Twin Fists of Malphon recently, sir. Fills me with the kind of battle hunger I'd not felt before. To think the empty hand could have as much destructive force as any weapon.
The empty hand has more destructive force than any weapon, lad. It is the only weapon that can wield all others. And without it, all others are nearly powerless. The Twin Fists are a testament to that. Use them with care.
Thank you.
All right, I think that's gonna do it for us today. Oof, jeez, that was only like an hour and a half, but I did. In my defense, I did like 3 hours earlier. I spent some time today going back and getting all those archives uploaded, so the archive should be pretty much updated, with the exception of yesterday and today's streams. And those will go up shortly. So, thank you all for popping in. I appreciate it. It's really nice hanging out with you guys and playing games, and it was a great way to make sure I didn't fucking doom scroll. Which I'm going to have to try really hard not to do. I appreciate you. Shucks. So, tomorrow, Stardew Valley Night. God, I can't believe I'm going to be due Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, 4 days in a row. But tomorrow, Stardew Valley Night. Caitlin and I are playing Stardew, presumably at like 7:30. You got to get those runs in. You got to. I still haven't gotten far, but I'm going to take a break for it for today, and excuse me. I wish I could stop getting hiccups. Jesus Christ. So, yeah, we'll be back tomorrow. And check out the YouTube channel if you're looking for some VODs. They're all up there. And I appreciate you guys hanging out. Thanks for being in chat. And if you were lurking, well, thank you for lurking, too. I do see you there every time, the few of you who pop in, and it really does mean a lot. So we'll get to you later. Bye.